What to Play presents the 10 best Android MMORPGs released this year, ranked by Gamer Review scores. Visit our website whattoplay.com to see the updated list of the biggest MMORPGs available on the Google Play Store. Starting with number 10, V4. This game is a little more of the usual MMORPG fare. Though its medieval fantasy setting might seem pretty standard, V4's dedication to visuals make it stand out from the crowd. Played out on an open-world environment, everything from the scenery to its character design is presented in exquisite detail. Their 6 classes of varying weapons and playstyles are all equipped to bring maximum damage to every battle. Against monsters with their automated battles or against other players in PvP. With its crossplay support, it makes it much easier to play alongside friends on the PC. It has a gamer score of 7. 9th place, Eve Echoes. Since 2003, Eve Online has amassed its own legion of fans for its dense, complicated space-based gameplay. This year, veteran space pilots got their fill of the action with this lightweight version of the original experience. Create your character from the 4 playable races and navigate the cosmos however you want. Whether it's space piracy, combat, and exploration. All of these paths are largely still available. It might put off more finicky Eve players, but it's still an impressive simplification of the full MMO experience. It has a gamer score of 7.4. 8th on our list is Aura Kingdom 2. Something for fans of anime-style RPGs. Travel to the world of Ramayan and save the world from being overrun by demons. Create your heroes from their 4 different classes, customize them from head to toe, and dress up in cool outfits. It also has a card game system in the form of Eidolons. There's up to 40 to collect, and each has its own powerful ultimate. As a free-to-play game, there will be a lot of grinding to get those rare cards and items, but their auto-battling system may just make it easier. It has a gamer score of 7.8. 7th place is Naruto Slugfest. There are already plenty of Naruto games out there, but this is the first to bring Konoha's ninjas to an open-world MMORPG. The game is based on the storyline of Naruto Shippuden, where you get to be a new ninja in the battle against the Akatsuki clan. For Naruto fans, Slugfest becomes a new way to be part of the world. With a partner system, you won't only meet your favorites, you can even summon them into battle. Still available in certain regions, the global release has been delayed indefinitely. Hopefully, it returns with more fixes as it gets a gamer score of a 7.8. At number 6 is Blade and Soul Revolution. With Revolution, Netmarble allows fans to relive the excitement of Blade and Soul on the mobile. It adds to the original's highly acclaimed storyline by exploring J-Bong's revenge. The title has been known for its martial arts combat, and Revolution's follow suit. Except it focuses more on skill combinations that almost makes it feel like a fighting game. Built on the Unreal Engine 4, it's a gorgeously flashy MMO with combat that could stand side by side with other popular AAA MMOs. It receives a gamer score of 8. Did you know your reviews can influence the play score? Register now at whattoplay.com and start reviewing games. Link on the description box below. 5th on our list is Stone Age World. Another one of Netmarble's recreations of a well-known name is this primitive MMO. Dive into the world of Tectonica and play the role of Guardian in the coming rise of machine life. Aside from the usual MMORPG quests and storylines, it also allows you to collect pets that have elemental features much like Pokemon. These double the role-playing elements as you can level up and equip stat-improving items to both your pets and the trainers. Unfortunately, as a free-to-play game, that means a whole lot of grinding too. Otherwise, it's a wonderful blend of RPG and monster collecting, and it gets a gamer score of 8.2. 4th place is Soul Worker Anime Legends. Afrogen's mobile adaptation of Game Forge's anime action MMORPG. With the success of their PC title, Legends delivers the same formula on the portable platform. Choose from 6 different heroes and battle the forces of evil with their signature rapid-fire combat. The characters will all be familiar to the fans of the series. Each has their own set of unlockable skills that are affected by their unique emotion system. It does have its share of flaws like bugs and lags, but if only for their beautiful hack-and-slash action, it receives a gamer score of 8.21. Third place goes to Light of Thel: Glory of Cepheus, a game from Singaporean publisher Yozu. This cute new MMORPG is packed with all sorts of activities in its expansive open world. Take on the role of a resistance hero and join the war against the demon invasion. All of that doesn't seem too scary in the face of its cartoon-style visuals and colorful characters. Other than the 10-player dungeons and monster collecting, other more casual pastimes like treasure hunting and fishing also exist. It receives a gamer score of an 8.40. Second place goes to Dragon Raja: Southeast Asia. One of the most anticipated MMORPG titles for the mobile, built on the Unreal Engine 4, this game never had any problems turning heads. On top of that, it also has a curious mix of Eastern and Western influences in its modern fantasy setting. In Dragon Raja, you carve your own path around the open world environment, where your choices affect how the captivating story unfolds. It's not flawless, especially with its seemingly pay-to-win customizations, but it's no doubt one of the most polished MMOs on the mobile. An immersive experience, it gets a gamer score of an 8.4. And our best Android MMORPG goes to Crisis S. Much like Dragon of Raja, Ifan's MMORPG is also an unusual marriage of fantasy and sci-fi tropes in a modern setting. There's definitely hints of Devil May Cry and Final Fantasy in its visuals. With a story revolving around stopping human enslavement and saving the love of your life, there's also a lot of intrigue in the game's plot. It's not groundbreaking, but it is one stylish and highly entertaining title. Is it a whole lot better than the rest of the list? Probably not. However, the people have spoken, and they have given it a gamer score of an 8.8.